Students, today's topic is the various method used in the sales forecasting. Yesterday we did the topic, the demand forecasting under the SCM. The next topic is the various methods. First of all, we will go towards the moving average method of sales forecasting. Under this, we will study the simple moving average, weighted moving average, and exponential moving average. In this method, the sales forecasting is obtained by taking average of past sales over a desired number of past period. That means whole moving average method is dependent on the past record. That means we must have the past data, then only we can use this technique. Extending the moving average to include more periods may increase the smoothing effect but decrease the sensitivity. That means if we increasing the number of periods under the moving average method, that will increase the, that is, that will smoothen the effect of sales forecasting, but it will decrease the sensitivity of the forecasting. So we will move towards the simple moving average. You all must studied this topic under the statistics, business statistics, in the MBA first semester. So I'm just giving you the overview of this. A simple moving average is formed by computing the average price of a security over a period of a specified number of periods. That means you will take the desired number of periods of which you have to do the sales forecast. Suppose you are doing, you have the 10 years data, then you can take the average of 10 years, and on the basis of that you will analyze the average you can say the average number of demand in the upcoming year. Suppose you have to find out the demand forecasting for the 11th year and you have the past data of 10 years, then you can make the average of that particular data of 10 years, and that will become the demand for the 11th year. So here is given the simple example. You all must have the notes with you, so you can go through the notes also. Next method is the weighted moving average. In the simple moving average, we assign the equal weightage to all the years. If the year is the past latest data, that means of the 10th year, we giving the same importance. And if the data is of first year, that we in that case also we giving the same importance. But under the weighted and moving average method, we assign the weightage to the specified years which has the more importance. We assign the highest number of weightage, and the year which has the lowest importance, we will assign the less number of weightage to that particular year. So we will look towards it. The moving averages calculated in the preceding part are known as the unweighted because the same weight is assigned to each of the numbers. As I said, told you, here it is an example given. You almost studied in the last semester, so I'm not going to tell the each and everything. You must get it with the help of this table. Okay, now we will go towards the advantages and disadvantages of this particular method, that is the moving average method. So first advantage is the, it is a simpler method than the least square method. You almost know about the least square method. In that particular method, we use the different kind of formulas, and on the basis of that, we find out the demand for the upcoming years. So moving average is the much simpler method as comparison to the least square. Second, this method is not affected by personal prejudice of the people. That means there is not the any people biasness with this method. If the period of moving average is equivalent to the period of the cycle, the cyclic variations are eliminated. That means if the data is of the seasonal data or the cyclic data, then in that case the weightage will be eliminated. If the trend in the data, if any, is linear, the moving average gives a good picture of the long-term movement in the data. That means if the data is the linear in the form, that means it is growing from the first year to the 10th year, then in that case, it will give the precise or the best result. And the last advantage is the moving average technique has a merit of flexibility. That means you can add or decrease, lessen the number of data, number of years which you want to take the in the calculation purpose. Next is the limitation of moving average method. It does not result in the mathematical relations which may be used for sales forecasting. That means it is based on the past data. We cannot justify, or we cannot say that it is accurate, 100% accurate. There is a tendency to cut corners which result in the loss of the data at the end. That means they can decrease or increase the number of years as per our choice. So it will lead to the loss of data. A great deal of care is needed for the selection of period. Obviously, if the company is 100 years old or 100 year ago, the company is established, then it is very critical to find out how much years we can take as a base year. In case of sharp turns in the original graph, the moving average would reduce the curvature. That means if the last year record, if we see the last year record, the graph is going upward and suddenly it moves downwards, there is a sharp turn. But when we take the moving average, it eliminates that particular factor of the curvature. And the last point is, it is very sensitive even to the small momentum data. That means if the last year sales forecast or the demand forecast is very minute or very less, then in that case it consider that particular thing also. It is very sensitive about that, the past year data. The third method which we use in the sales forecasting is the exponential smoothing and moving average method. This is the finest, or we can say this is the latest method which we can use, but is very much critical and which very much calculative. The form, this method of sales forecasting is a modification of moving average, or in better words, it is an improvement over the moving average. What we do in this particular pattern is, we keep the most sensitive part of most important parts, we give the highest value to that particular, and less weightage to the lowest year in the geometric progression. Okay, so here we will not assign the weightage according to our will, we will assign the weightage according to the geometric progressions. Since the most recent observations are likely to reflect up-to-date information, so we will give the more weightage to the most recent data or most up-to-date information. And this method keeps a running average of demand and adjusts it for each period in proportion to the difference between the latest actual demand and the latest value of the average. So here is the formula given: Fn is equal to Fn minus 1 plus alpha Dn minus 1 minus Fn minus 1, where Fn is the forecast for the next period which we are going to conduct. Fn minus 1 is the forecasting for the previous data which we have. Dn minus 1 is the demand in previous period. And for in that case, here's the example is given, you can see with your notes. And if in case you find any query, you can ask me. So tomorrow we will going to do the supply chain efficiency core, reversing supply chain. Till then, you will study this particular methods. Thank you.